right, so here are the five elements of a personal brand. The first one is you need to have a defined audience, right? So the first thing you should realize about a personal brand is that your personal brand is not about you, right? At the end of the day, your personal brand has a whole lot more to do with the audience that you're speaking to. And when we are clear on who we're speaking to, then everything else about our decision regarding our personal brand and what aspects to highlight about ourselves that will resonate with others, those things will rise to the surface and it will become very clear. It'll be easy to pick out. It'll become obvious to us what to focus on and what not to focus on, right? So this is really important. We need to be clear about who we're speaking to. So a great example of this is like moms, right? So if your audience is moms, they might not have time to read a whole blog. Therefore, if you are a good speaker, then you're going to want to lean into videos or podcasts, something they can listen to while they're doing the dishes or have headphones in while they're watching it and putting the baby to sleep, right? So think about your audience. This is going to tell you what aspects of your personality and your strengths to highlight. And also it's going to be a resonant point, right? What's resonating between you and your audience? It's going to compel them to continue listening to you and your personality. Cool. The second thing that is a part of your personal brand, the second element, is a unique value proposition. Very fancy language, right? But really, what's your special sauce? What's your special spark? What's your secret sauce? It is the thing that sets you apart in a saturated industry. And here's the thing. If we lean into our personal strengths, no one can imitate us. We are the unique value proposition. And that's a really cool thing as a personal brand. We're not really needing to differentiate a product in the market. We are utilizing ourselves to differentiate in the market. And we have total permission. And actually, it's an asset to be your kind of goofy, weird self and embrace those quirks that sometimes we're not so confident about and lean into them. And so also on top of that, what is the problem that you're solving it? And are you solving it in a way that hasn't been done before? Or maybe you're solving it the same way, but with a twist, right? Maybe you're doing it in a fun way. Maybe you're doing it quicker. Maybe speed isn't important. Maybe it's quality that you're looking at, right? So what is unique about the way you're solving someone's pain point or problem and getting them to the benefits and solutions that they're looking for? Cool. So that was number two. Number three, and this is where we really get to lean into the personal side of personal branding. So we really need to have a compelling personality and style. And so this is where we get to have fun. We get to explore what it is that we like, what it is that we don't like. And again, we're keeping our audience in mind. What is also going to resonate with them? What are they going to respond to? Are they particular about a certain brand? Are they loyal to a certain brand, right? Is that something that you both value? Lean into that. Maybe it's an article of clothing. If you're a beauty guru, like, is it a makeup brand? Is it hair products? Is it Warby Parker's that you're all about? Because I've got some Warby's, right? Figure out what those things are, what those common denominators, and stand on them. Like, have fun with this. Use your personality. Use your humor. Use your dry wit. Like, whatever it is that you have, lean into it here. And then start to capture that visually. Start to pull it together. And the way that we start, the very first thing that someone asked me, like, what should I do to put my personality and my personal brand out there, is a great headshot. Right? The best way to start developing a personal brand is to figure out how this is best represented on the outside. So whatever's inside, how do I best represent that on the outside, my values and things, and represent that physically, right? With clothing or hairstyle or makeup or how you articulate your words, right? So can't really see that in a picture, but maybe it's video, right? A headshot or a talking head video introducing yourself. That is a really, really good way to get yourself started creating your visuals for your personal brand. You can also develop clarity around your values and your goals, right? So maybe your goal is not necessarily to make buku's amounts of money. Maybe your goal is to make an impact, right? So get clear about that, and that's going to shine through in your personality the more you get clear on your values. It also helps you to repel those who are not your people and attract those who are. And this is really important because we can't be everybody's cup of tea, right? Some people like it black, some people like it green, some people like it sweet, right? So we have to figure out what we're for, what we're against, what we're about, what we're not, and also what's off limits about talking about. So there are some people who are much more open in the online space about their personal life, and that's totally fine. That is a decision that they've made. But there are also families who've said, you know, I'm not going to post any pictures of my little ones, and that is a line that I don't want to cross. So figure out what is feeling good to you and what does not feel good to you to present to the world in the online space. And this is not, you know, hiding anything. This is called boundaries. We should all have them in our lives, in our offline relationships, right? And so to have them online totally makes sense. And you have permission to do that. I needed to hear that when I was first coming into the online space because I didn't know how much to share. And naturally, I'm not an oversharer. But it was something that I felt compelled, like I had to share all of my stuff if I was going to be a personal brand. And when I found out that there was a way to be vulnerable, to be transparent in the online space that wasn't icky or oversharing or felt like I was airing dirty laundry, right? I think we've all seen people who've done it and we're like, oh, that doesn't resonate with me. So I haven't gotten to number four yet. I'm still number three, Tuan. Number three is compelling personality and style. Number two, again, is unique value proposition. And number one is a defined audience. So number four is a compelling message, a compelling brand message. And oftentimes this gets tied up in a neat little box with a bow on top and we call it a tagline. If it is for a product, it's also called a slogan. So you can have one overarching tagline or a jingle or whatever it is that you want it to be. And then for individual products, you have a slogan for those different products, okay? So, you know, Seth Godin has one, just go make something happen. Like, that's his thing. See if you can name this slogan. This one's really easy. This is a giveaway, right? Just do it. Everybody knows whose tagline that is. Just do it. Another one is, it's finger licking good, right? We all have heard that. It makes us hungry. It makes us think about going to KFC. And then he keeps going and going and going and going, right? That's the Energizer Bunny. Very recognizable taglines, all having to do with the product or company that it represents. And so it's very compelling. It's very catchy. It's very recognizable. And so what's really important for us is to figure out in a personal brand way, communicate very quickly who we're serving, what problem we're solving, and the benefit that we're bringing to them, right? So I help online entrepreneurs create captivating brands so they can convert clients. Done, right? So make sure it's compelling. Make sure that it's clear. And, you know, it's okay to play around with this. It's going to take you a minute to dial this in. If you're not really sure what's landing, try something for 90 days and see how it lands. If it's not landing well with people or it just feels jumbly in your mouth, try something different for the next 90 days. This is something that kind of takes some evolving in the beginning. For other people, it's very clear and you can just run with it. So you have permission to change this. And it does take a minute to maybe dial it in for some people. So don't feel like you have to be married to the first thing that you come up with. And then lastly, and this is the part where everybody wants to start, and I'm going to tell you don't start here. But number five is a clean and consistent visuals, right? Clean and consistent visuals. And so this is where you might end up commissioning a professionally designed logo or working with someone to help you decide on a fixed color palette. These are your brand colors that you utilize across all of your platforms so that you have that consistency. And then brand fonts. I highly recommend starting with one or two and focusing on your products and being visible and just marketing and not getting too fancy in the beginning, especially if you're not clear about your audience, if you're not super clear about your product or your offering, keep it incredibly simple so that it at a minimum is consistent and clean across all of the platforms, right? We don't wanna overdo this and make it overcomplicated and say, this doesn't actually appeal to my market and I've gotta change everything around, right? Brand visuals should be the last thing that we do, and it's built off of and informed by the defined audience, the unique value proposition, the compelling personality that you want to stand on, and your brand message. Cool? So those are the five elements of a personal brand. I'd love to hear from you guys. Which is one that you feel like is something that you're working on right now, or which which one is the one that needs the most work? Because these change, these vary, right? As we grow and shift and pivot in our business and say, ah, that didn't work, or hey, this is working really well, I should lean more into that. You know, some of this shifts and tweaks. So I'd love to hear from you guys who are watching. If you're watching the replay, type in hashtag replay and let me know also at the end of this what you guys are thinking. Are you needing to work on redefining your audience? Are you needing to figure out how to stand out more in your saturated industry? That's a real thing that we're all struggling with, right? So also called your unique value proposition, but how do you stand out? Are you clear on what aspects of your personality that you want to highlight or that you want to lean into as far as resonance is concerned or your values that you have in common with your audience? I see all five. Oh gosh. Yeah. I mean, if you're at the beginning of starting a company, then yes, you need to consider all five. Start with number one, define your audience. And then lastly, your brand visuals. Hiring Brittany Rossi for all five. Yes, I'm a fan of that. Do it. So have fun with this. Don't feel overwhelmed by it. This is a work in process, and it is something that should be revisited once in a while, not too frequently. You should focus on the visibility part and connecting with people. But if these elements, if this foundation isn't here, the rest of the business won't stand very well. And so this is really important to make sure you're dialed into, or you're at least in tune enough with that, you know, something is off with my brand. I need to look at my five elements and see which one of these I need to lean into. And each one of these, you could spend a good amount of time on defining the audience. I mean, within large companies, there's a whole department dedicated to the defined audience. Hello, I'm not sure who this is, Bea. Oh, hi, it's so good to see you. Thank you for joining me today. It's so nice to have you here. So don't put too much pressure on yourselves with these things. Tackle it one at a time. All right. So I'd love to hear from you. I want to see below if you are trying to launch your personal brand or you're getting ready to launch a product, which of these things sounds like something, an area where you're going to need to lean into a little bit more strongly. And I would love to provide support for you around that. If you want to drop it into the comments, either on Instagram or in the Facebook community, feel free to do that. And I will be happy to point you in the right direction and get you some momentum in some of those areas. So that's it for today. I hope that you guys found this really helpful and clarifying for you as you guys continue to build your personal brands. It is always a work in progress. So you guys have a wonderful and productive rest of your evening. If you're on the West Coast, if you're on the East Coast, I hope that you're wrapping up and getting ready for dinner. So that's it. Thanks for joining me, guys. I will talk to you soon. See you later.